Are you ready to shred the sky? The DJI Avata is here. FPV freedom meets cinematic smoothness. I'm going to take you through my own personal experience, so stick around so you don't miss anything. I've never flown a FPV drone before, and the Avata is essentially a hybrid drone. More on that later. I'll share with you the good and the bad of this drone. Quick disclaimer, I did purchase this myself, used off of eBay. So I'm going to share with you some very unedited, raw facts about this drone. So buckle up, it's going to be wild.
A couple disclaimers here. I have no idea what I'm doing with this. I just bought it off of eBay, scored it for a pretty good price. So here we are, got it all charged. I need to hook it all up to my phone. And I already got authorization for airspace, so I'm good. Hopefully, I don't crash this thing. It's supposed to be mostly idiot-proof, right? Ah! This has a holder strap for the battery that it came with. I gotta push and hold the battery. There we go. So we'll put that down. Ooh. Needs to be a hard surface. So I updated the firmware, and this actually smells like new sneakers, which is kind of weird. So I pushed and held the red button, and that just beeped. So I can move the gimbal on the camera, but it's not starting. Why? And now I'm stuck in a virtual flight thing that wants me to open a different app. Okay, so I slapped the button a few times and then it got me out. Not intuitive, DJI. Okay, so there was a go fly button on the phone. Let's see if this does anything. Okay, I double tapped the red button. These goggles suck. So that's normal and sport mode here on the button that has the letter M on it. So I had to push and hold it. My dogs were a little freaked out. Weird. I'm pulling the trigger and it's going backwards. Come on. Ah. I don't know what the deal is with this. Let's try moving it over. I know it's got a low battery, but I'm gonna have to read up on this. This is not intuitive. Well, I don't know if this is gonna take off because I updated the database for the no-fly zones. Although I did call and get authorization.
It's funny because you'd think that you wouldn't have to call the air traffic control to be able to take off and land inside of your own garage and not go outside or even fly in your own house. But legally, you have to get authorization. How it is still.
Flying a drone takes precision and problem solving, just like learning with today's sponsor, Brilliant.org. Brilliant.org offers interactive lessons in math, science, and computer science, designed to help you learn by doing. Whether you're brushing up on foundational skills or tackling advanced topics, Brilliant's hands-on approach makes complex ideas easy to understand. Join millions of learners and start building skills that can help with anything from physics to coding your own projects. Visit brilliant.org/shinytechthings for 30 days of free access and receive a 20% discount off the annual premium membership using the links below or with the QR code.
So I finally got the controller paired up with the Avata, and that was kind of a pain. Let's see if it'll take off. It says unable to take off, and it is not letting me take off at all. Oh, here we go. This is unlocked for takeoff. So tap unlock, let's see what it does. So now I should be able to fly like I'm using my Autel. It's interesting, it picked up another airport and says I need authorization from there.
And technically it shouldn't, so the GPS is not as accurate as it could be. I might be able to make that, but I really don't want to risk that much money because it's not that stable yet. Let's see if we can maybe calibrate it.
So much easier to fly with this if you're used to flying a drone. So I think it's just the amount of GPS connections that it has. I've recalibrated everything. It still flies about the same. So now I will just fly around this, I guess. Okay, well that was kind of intense. It had its moments, and it's interesting, it wants to unlock again.
Now I'm going to take you outside so there's plenty of space to just fly around.
So I'm gonna try using this remote again here. The Pro remote is definitely more intuitive, at least for me being a previous drone pilot, but I'm going to double tap, and it turns it on. And then now I'm going to press and hold and get further back here, and it should lift off. I'm holding the trigger down. Let me fly over here. Let's get close to the ground. Let's see if we can get a little bit closer. Now let's just book it. Now I'm in sports mode. Getting a little nauseous, but get used to it. Back in normal mode. I'm pressing and holding the red button here. And perfect. So now I've got the Pro controller, and I just turned off the other controller and turned this one on. And it works, so that's cool. I did get this remote set up previously, so it does just reconnect automatically once you turn it on, which is nice. And with the Pro remote here, we can adjust the gimbal. You can also do that on the other remote, but I am not used to doing that yet. There we go. And one thing, I need to see if you can see this. These goggles get condensation on the inside. So I'm gonna have to look and see if I can find some kind of anti-fog stuff to put on here, but I'll need to research it before I apply it, just in case, because I don't want to damage this because it's pricey. I can't think of the dogs barking. Quiet. If flying an FPV drone is intimidating to you, this might be the drone to check out. And that's because you can switch it from full manual mode, which is absolutely terrifying, back over to a mode that has more safety, where when you release the controls, the drone will stop. And you can do that just with a flick of the switch on the front of the Pro controller. So if you like drones, check out this playlist here, or YouTube says you might want to watch this.